a lot of people may be dismissing Bitcoin, but that's where the trading is at right now, at least.
Well, it's a funny thing, right? So the Bitcoin is whatever, $9,000. Median family income in the U.S., about $45,000 to $50,000. Most Americans are not participating in this. There's about 300,000 transactions a day in Bitcoin, compared to millions of transactions on credit cards. This is something that's for mostly wealthy people who have that money that they're willing to, like, lose if they're wrong.
Do you know where the trade is, though? Right now, we're seeing a lot of trades being done in developing nations as well. How can you keep an eye on where the money is flowing from and to?
Sure. So that's precisely the problem, because of the decentralized nature of these cyber currencies. But I think that the volume numbers suggest that a couple of centers in Asia are big. China used to be the biggest, but what they began doing was putting a transaction cost, like a commission fee. And that slowed down. So now China makes up about 20% of the market. South Korea is big. Japan is big. You know, after Mt. Gox failed, Japan began regulating Bitcoins. And so because it's more regulated, people feel it's safer. And so we see Japan, also most recently in Zimbabwe, when they had their problems.
Right, the military takeover.
Yep, and so some people began, like, thinking maybe it's Zimbabwe and is it this flight to safe haven or something like that.
So beyond the idea that, you know, retail investors shouldn't go anywhere near this thing, or really anybody, I guess, is your point, does it bring up any interesting issues? Its existence.
Well, I think what the amazing thing to me is there's a lot of people on Wall Street who think that the government is part of the problem, not part of the solution. And yet with the Bitcoins, it's just about an unregulated market as we can imagine. And yet you can see what happens when we don't have rules and referees. We don't know about transparency. Could a small order move the market? How do we fill these things? You know, in the markets, we're talking about a two-day settlement, say, on stocks. For some of these cyber currencies, it could be like a 5 or 6 day between the time you buy it and the time you get delivered. The kind of risk that there is, this is still very, who knows where it's going to evolve to, but it still seems very risky for individuals.